Specifications, device installation types, comparison, application, then pros and cons. First, Instion overview. So, Instion is a dual band network technology used to control devices which are made for home management systems. So, basically, it is used to control light switches, dimmers, and motion sensors. Okay, next. Dual band in the sense it supports both RF and power line. RF, you already know, radio frequency, which is more advanced of IR. And power line, which is a communication, which is parallel, simultaneously works to AC current. And Instion is mesh, follows mesh topology, which has each nodes, let us consider as node. So, a node which can receive data and it transfer whatever data they receive, it transfer the data to the neighboring nodes. So there are more than 100 nodes. Those technologies called mesh topology. And it's initially designed by Smart Labs and manufactured with smartphone. Currently, Instion has its own marketing step. It has products and brands. How it works. So first of all, Instion has two different devices, Instion Hub and the Link device. So first you have to configure your app through the Instion Hub. Then the commands in the app, when you send some commands through the app, it will contact the Instion Hub so that the Instion Hub sends Instion signals to the relevant Smart Link or IR Link controls. So Smart Link is used to control switch enabled device and IR Link is used to control IR enabled device. So basically the apps are available in Android, iOS and PC desktop software. And Instion Hub is web-based controller so that you can work this technology anywhere. So single hub can control more than 256 Smart Link or IR Link controls. Message structure of Instion. So basically there are two different message structure in Instion. One is standard message with 10 bytes and extended message with 24 bytes. The only difference is extended message having user data field. So the first 3 bytes is allocated for from address, which is message originator address. And the next 3 bytes allocated for to address, which is recipient address. It's having the details of device type, what they are using, firmware, and version information. After the 6 bytes, next 7th byte is allocated for flag. In that flag 1 byte, it has 8 bits. So the bits separated by message type, acknowledgement, maximum ups and offslip. Message type is what type of message it sends. Acknowledgement, whether the signal received properly or not, it acknowledges. And the third one, maximum ops. Maximum ops in the sense, it's reattempted. So how many times it sends? Once it got fails, it will reattempt. So the number of reattempt is maximum hops. And the other one is number of hops left. So basically the maximum hops will be 3. So once first time if it fails, then the maximum hops will be 2. The number of hops will be the remaining. Next one, the next 2 bytes is for command, the normal command. It's used to operate the system or device. And user defined command in the sense user can teach their own command to perform some operation in the device. The last 2 bytes is for CRC, which is cyclic redundancy check, used to detect and correct errors.
specification or instant devices are peers. So peers in the sense mesh topology follows. So it can receive signals, transfer and repeats data again and again. If the signal doesn't have any error, it won't repeat. If it has error, then it will repeat this same signal again and again. Frequency range. So Instion is basically dual band. In that dual band, it has power line as well as RF. So power line has a frequency of 131 kHz and RF in the range of 9 up to 924 MHz. Then capabilities of Instion. Maximum devices per network will be nearly 1.7 crore. And scene in the sense it's activity. So that you can create some activity or scene. Just like turn on a light on sometime. After 10 minutes, turn off the light. And after 10 minutes, dim the light control with some settings like that. These are here mentioning as scenes. So maximum scenes applicable for a device is 256. So there are three installation types of Instions. The first one is wiring, which is manual wiring with a switchboard. The second one is plug-in. So you can simply plug in into the switchboard and you can access it. And the third one is battery power. Similar to Instion, there are three more competitors, Xtern, ZigBee and Z-Wave. Here is the quick comparison of these technologies. First one is dual mesh. So as I already told earlier, dual mesh in the sense it has power line and RF. So no other Xtern, ZigBee, Z-Wave. No one having those facilities. Xtern having power line communication, whether ZigBee and Z-Wave have RF communications. In that, their data rates of power line communication and their data rates of RF communication is comparatively low when you compare to Instion. And maximum devices per network, also Instion having the high number of devices to connect through a single network. And Xtern compatible, last one. So Xtern is also a technology. Initially it was only compatible with Xtern manufacturer. So now Instion having that capability too. But no Instion devices having that capability of Xtern. So these are the applications where Instion using simple light switch having this technology and have heating, ventilation and air conditioning. And AV devices, audio video devices like TV, AVR receiver like that. House security systems in the sense door locks, similar devices. Irrigation in the sense power pumps. Pros and cons. So pros in the sense it's easy to handle, easy to configure, and it's reliable, very fast data, right? Cons, it's high cost when compared to Xtern and any other technology. It's relatively high cost and it requires high bandwidth. So the main motivation of Instion is that instead of putting the switch on to make your device control, instead of putting your switch, a simple click, make a device on. Thank you.
I hate anybody having questions. Where is anyway?
Which way? Instion is on your point of view.